For much of the past 6 months, since the federal election failed to find a clear winner, the Social Democrats have appeared divided, stuck between the ideological desire to oppose Angela Merkel and the pragmatic need for Germany to have a stable government. On Sunday, the party's grassroots had their say.
Mit Ja haben gestimmt
239,604 SPD members voted yes. 123,329 SPD members voted no. This represents a two-thirds yes vote and one-third no vote.
This was a decision of the head, not the heart. Many members agonized over their choice. Some feared how the electorate will perceive another grand coalition. In the weeks leading up to the vote, the party youth movement was vociferously opposed, saying election losers should lick their wounds and not work with Angela Merkel. But the politician who is likely to be the next finance minister welcomed Sunday's result.
We now have clarity. The SPD will join the next government. Our party did not make this decision lightly. This will now give us the strength we need to move forward as a party in government and to put our country on the right path.
But some analysts believe it's questionable whether that path will benefit the Social Democrats long term.
Yes, their core brand is social justice, but it has to be more in order to actually be over 20 or over 30%. Because what they're claiming for, they still want to be a Volkspartei. And what does that label mean? It actually means, or how is it defined, 30% and more of the vote. And they're far away from that.
In the end, the party's members have decided to put the interests of the country above the interests of their party. But the point to make here, as they contemplate another coalition with Angela Merkel's Christian Democrats, is it's now many, many years since their party has been in a position to win an election and to provide the Chancellor as a Social Democrat. Dominic Kane, Al Jazeera, Berlin.